Hi, I am Tushar Pendharkar, filling in for Shalini. Welcome to another edition of Weekend with Ventura. We have Mr. Vinit Bolinjkar to discuss recently announced Q3 FY19 results.
Hi, Tushar.
Hello, sir.
Several companies from different sectors reported their numbers in last week. So, can we start with the banking sector?
Sure. So, in banks actually, IndusInd, Bandhan, AU, Dhanlakshmi, Jammu and Kashmir Bank came out with the results. And while DCB disappointed with slight increase in your NPAs along with Federal, the other numbers were pretty okay. But one which was a very startling result was that of J&K Bank, where they were giving very bullish guidance over the next 4 to 5 years on profitability. So that is one result which really stuck with me. And in the large caps, IndusInd Bank were good numbers. They kept up with all their operating metrics, you know. But the only thing is that, you know, that IL&FS numbers which are there draws a little discomfort. So I think we will, while you know, we have an ad on the stock, we will be looking to buy the bank only on bad days when there are dips in the market.
Several IT companies reported their numbers and most of them reported very good numbers. So, which you liked most?
Yeah. So, you know, barring for Infosys, I think all the other guys did well except for the engineering company, which was Cyient and Tata Elxsi. But there, I think L&T Services did very well. It was an extremely good result. Agreed, the stock is slightly more expensive in the entire pack. But definitely the performance deserves the valuation that it gets. Apart from that, I think TCS, big boy, always is, market is valuing it at higher extremes. You know, expectations are very high and people said it was a disappointment. But I think that the numbers were pretty alright. For a large cap stock going at the rate that they have done, I think it warrants attention. So to my mind, the stocks which did well this quarter were Wipro came out with good numbers, but the guidance was weak. TCS was very good, and we like L&T Services.
Though no major auto company in large cap space reported their numbers yet, but there are 3-4 players, ancillary players who reported their numbers. What is your view on those 3-4?
So, you know, they are a miss. They can be left out. But GA Max has really stuck with me. You know, it did a 44% growth in both top line, EBITDA and PAT. Okay, available at 10.5 times. And, you know, there's a huge thrust on CVs with multi-axle vehicles, because of which GA Max is a very natural beneficiary. So, although the CV cycle is going down and, you know, we might expect some kind of slowdown, but I really think this is one sector where investors should take a look, especially GN and Axles, given the fact that once the auto cycle turns around, I think GN Axles along with automotive axles will be a very good stock to look at.
Another fancy sector for the investors are the chemical segment, and few companies reported in that space also. What is your view on the sector and the companies?
So we continue to remain very positive. I think the large cap stocks like Nosil, Atul, Ati will continue to do well. Atul reported this week very good numbers, and at 21 times I think the stock may look a tad expensive, but given the kind of fanciness for chemical stocks, they'll do well. Another stock which did really well was Phillips Carbon, you know, at 7.5 times book, 7.5 times trailing multiple. I think that stock really deserves to warrant attention. Apart from this, you know, other player which got beaten down in the market because of an expansion into this was BKT. Yeah, they moved into carbon black and they were beaten down. So I think investors should take a re-look at vibration tires also. Mangalam Organics came out with numbers, huge numbers, very big growth. And one very small stock called TGV SRACC came out with numbers. That is one stock which investors should keep their eyes on. It's a small cap, but you know, I think they've got some very interesting developments happening out there that also really deserves attention.
Many consumer stocks reported their numbers, especially HUL. They did very well. So what is your view on that segment?
So I think HUL was a real outlier, fantastic growth, double digit volume growth, 11% for 4 to 5 consecutive quarters. Now they've shown double digit growth, and you know, that is speaking the GST story which is actually panning out. You not only have that, you have got EBITDA expansion. They did about 22% EBITDA, and you know, they've also guided further for capital employed shrinkage, so warehouse rationalization, you know, and other measures will come in which will really boost ROC. So today, if you see the entire space of FMCG stocks, okay, HUL has got double the ROC of the entire FMCG segment, whereas its valuation on a paying ratio is one of the cheapest. So I think it definitely deserves a investment in our portfolio. It may, you know, optically the P is very high, but it is a really good stock to have in your portfolio. Another stock which really did well was Zee Delhi, you know, in the media space. Fantastic numbers, growth in advertising as well as subscribers. And however, there is that disruption coming in from that, you know, individual channel that Tri has recommended. So the stock could be a little soft. You know, we have seen Sun TV collapse a lot. Okay, apart from that, TV18, Network 18, its parent, other stocks like, you know, the ones who are into publishing, MPS, they came out with decent numbers. So, you know, I think it's been a very good week for all these stocks, and really I would like to emphasize that HUL is a good stock to look at, and investors should buy on declines.
But we missed Avenue Supermarket.
Avenue Supermarkets is extremely overvalued in my opinion. Okay, I hold an opinion which is very contrary to the street. I believe that the growth is slowing down. So although you have good top line growth, 33%, they've compromised on margins. So the margin growth is not coming in, and we've had now had 2-3 quarters of slowdown in growth. So I believe that unless they do not do rapid rollout of stores as per what they said, I think the valuation per store also will take into consideration. I don't know when they will achieve those numbers. So to my mind, Avenue Supermarkets, I will give it a miss.
Before we let you go, what about Big Boy Reliance, Kajaria, and our coverage of stock Trident?
So let me talk about Kajaria first. Okay, I think given the circumstances in which the stock is, you know, the real estate sector is so beaten down, I think 10% top line growth, 24% bottom line growth is fantastic performance. Okay, it commands much higher margins than the entire industry. So this stock does warrant attention. But at 29 times FY20, I think the stock is not a tad. I think it's quite expensive. So I would wait to buy the stock in decline. And what to talk of Big Boy Reliance, you know, CapEx cycle getting over, digital ROC is expanding, cash cow businesses like your refining, beating estimates one after the other, you know, and it's available at 13 times FY21. So I think this stock should be there in everyone's portfolio, and I don't think that it's too late to buy this stock. I definitely think there's a lot of money to be made, and there's a lot of money left on the table also. So I like that. And speaking of Trident, you know, so it's in textiles, home textiles. They're making good steady progress. They're into the paper segment. 8.5 times good profit growth, turnover also grew very well. So we continue to like this stock given its single digit valuation.
We discussed so many results with you, and there are yet to come many results. So until then, stay tuned.
Yes, and do not forget to check out Ventura's YouTube channel and also visit us on Facebook at Ventura Securities. And what's more, if you want some more entertaining stories of this nature, you can check them out on blog.ventura1.com. Until next week, bye.